Actually, in this talk, we are going to highlight various Boolean algebra of word languages from automata for which vertices are Mazurkiewicz traces. First, let us give a simple example to show the interest of Boolean algebra. Let us consider word automatic graphs. So such a graph is just a graph for which each relation is recognized by a finite synchronized transducer. So for example, here you have the infinite quarter grid. Its vertices are words, and this one edge between the word AB and the word AAB is recognized by this finite synchronized transducer. It starts by reading the couple AA, then it reads the couple BA, and then it reads the couple empty word B, and it accepts. And so Hodgson showed that the first order theory of any word automatic graph is decidable. And in fact, this result essentially relies on the closure properties of the regular languages, the closure properties that make this class a Boolean algebra. So, in formal language theory, a well-known hierarchy of formal language is defined by Chomsky from grammars of increasing complexity. So first you have the regular languages, then the context-free, the context-sensitive, and the recursively enumerable languages. And if it's well known that regular or context-sensitive languages form a Boolean algebra, that is a class of language closed under intersection and complementation, it's also well known that it's not the case for context-free languages. So in this talk, we will provide various Boolean algebra, in particular of context-sensitive languages. And we will obtain Boolean algebra from automata. So for us, an automaton is just a graph plus initial and final vertices. And this automaton may be infinite. So more formally, we start from a set V of possibly vertices, a set T of terminal symbols, terminal letters, and a set of two colors, iota and O. And an automaton G over V is just the union of some labeled edges and colored vertices. A labeled edge is a triple of the form a vertex, a terminal letter, a vertex. And a colored vertex is just a couple of the form a color and a vertex. And so the vertices of our automaton are just the vertices that appear in a labeled edge or as a colored vertex. The initial vertices are the vertices colored by iota, and the final vertices are the vertices colored by O. And so the language accepted by our automaton is just the word language that labels a path from an initial vertex to a final one. So let us give an example of automata. Let us consider word suffix automata. So a word suffix automaton is defined from, in fact, a word rewriting system that is a finite set of word rewriting rules. Each rule owns a context that is a regular word language, a left-hand side and a right-hand side that are just words. And so a word suffix automaton is just the suffix rewriting graph of such a rewriting system. And so we also have some initial vertices and final vertices that are supposed regular. In fact, word suffix automata are essentially the configuration graphs of pushdown automata. And so word suffix automata accept exactly the context-free languages. So here we have an example. So for the vertices, we have the letters P, Q, and bottom. To make an edge labeled by A, you just have to push the letter bottom. An edge labeled by B, you just switch the state P to the state Q. And to make an edge labeled by C, you just have to pop the letter bottom. And so the language accepted by this word suffix automaton is the language of AN, BCN. So a crucial notion in our paper to obtain Boolean algebra is the notion of reduction of automata. So we will say that an automaton is reducible to another one just if there exists a mapping from the set of vertices of G to the set of vertices of H that preserves the labeling of the edges and the coloring of the vertices. Such a mapping is just a morphism. And observe that if G is reducible to H, then the language accepted by G is a subset of the language accepted by H. And suppose, moreover, that G and H are over a common set of vertices, for example, set of words, and that this set is equipped of a lymph mapping, that is, we have a notion of lymph, then we will say that G is lymph reducible to H, if G is reducible to H, and moreover, the reduction preserves the lymph. So let us give an example. So here we have the infinite binary tree encoded as usual, and here we have this automaton. We'll come back later to this notation. Just observe that when you go down here, the lymph is increased of one. And so the infinite binary tree is lymph reducible to this automaton. In fact, all the vertices of a given level of this infinite binary tree have the same lymph and are mapped to the corresponding this automaton. So a well-known Boolean algebra of context-free languages was defined by Allure and Madhusudan as the visibly pushed-down languages. And in fact, this Boolean algebra can be characterized in terms of automata reduction. So we start from a triple of disjoint alphabets, and we consider this visibly pushed-down automaton. So we have for the vertices the letter bottom and the letter top. In fact, any letter in T1 increases the stack of one. Any letter in T minus one decreases the stack of one. And any letter in T0 doesn't affect the length of the stack. And in fact, the context-free languages accepted by the word suffix automata that are length reducible to this visibly pushed-down automaton form exactly the Boolean algebra of visibly pushed-down languages respect to this triple of disjoint finite alphabets. And in fact, there is a more general way to obtain Boolean algebra of context-free languages. It is a work of Kokal and Rispal. So they show that, in fact, you can choose any deterministic word suffix automaton, H, and the context-free languages accepted by the deterministic word suffix automata that are lymph reducible to this H form a Boolean algebra. For example, we can choose this H, that is no more a visibly pushed-down automaton, since A here increases the stack, and here it decreases the stack. So, another type of automata is given by vector addition systems. So vector addition system is an automaton over natural number vectors. It is defined from a finite set of action. An action is an integer vector. And you have an edge labeled by A. If A labels between two natural number vectors, if A labels an integer vector, such that when it is added to the first natural number vector, you obtain the second one. And so the question arises of which Boolean algebra can be obtained from vector addition systems. So on one end, we have pushdown graphs. On the other end, we have vector addition systems. So to obtain Boolean algebra and to take concurrent systems into account, we are going to consider a third model given by Mazurkiewicz traces. So here I recall the basic definitions. So to obtain traces, we start from a dependence alphabet, that is a finite alphabet, sigma, and a reflexive and symmetric binary relation on sigma. It is a dependence relation. the complement of the dependent relation is the independent relation. And so on the free monoid sigma star, you consider the least congruence such that if two letters are independent, two letters A and B, then the words AB and BA are equivalent. So the trace of a word is just its equivalence class, and the trace monoid M sigma D is just the quotient monoid of the free monoid sigma star under the trace equivalence. And a crucial notion in the paper is that any trace admits a normal form called its Fuata normal forms. So in fact, any trace admit a unique decomposition level by level, here are the levels, such that all letters in a given level are mutually independent, and any letter in a given level is dependent from a letter in the previous level. So for example here, given this dependence alphabet, we can consider this trace, the trace of this word, and so here you have this trace, and it is encoded as the word AC, the word BD, the word A, the word B. And so the length of a trace will be the length of its Fuata normal form seen as a word. So for example, here we have four levels, so the length of the trace will be four. And so now we can state the main theorem of the paper. So consider any family of trace automata. So trace automaton is just an automaton for which vertices are traces. And suppose that this family is closed under two operations, level length synchronization and level length superposition. We will come back later on these operations. Then you can choose any deterministic automaton in this family. The languages accepted by the deterministic automata in this family that are length reducible to this H form a Boolean algebra. In fact, it's a Boolean algebra relative to the language accepted by H. That is, it is closed under intersection. All the languages are subset of the language accepted by H. And it is closed under difference compared to the language accepted by H. And so this operation, we'll come back later, ensures the closure under intersection and complementation. So now we are going to apply this theorem to some particular families of trace automata. The first one will be the extension to measure Kevich's traces of word suffix automata. But before, we have to, in fact, consider a weaker notion of recognizability in the trace monoid. So we will say that the trace language is level regular just if the word language of the Fuata normal forms of its elements is regular. And it is a weaker notion of the notion of recognizability in trace monoid because the recognizable trace language is level regular. Here is a characterization of recognizable trace languages. But suppose that A and B are independent, then the trace language AB star is level regular but not recognizable because its union is a set of words over A and B with the same number of A and the same number of B that is obviously not regular. So now we can consider the extension to word suffix, the extension of word suffix automata to measure Kevich's traces. So we have a trace rewriting system that is a finite set of rules. Each rule owns a context that is level regular, that is a level regular trace language, a left-hand side and a right-hand side that are just traces. So a trace suffix automaton is just the suffix rewriting graph of this trace rewriting system. And we have sets of initial vertices and final vertices that are supposed level regular. And so languages accepted by trace suffix automata, in fact, are context sensitive because we prove that trace suffix automata are word automatic and the context-sensitive languages are exactly accepted by word suffix automatic graphs. Here is an example of a trail suffix automaton. So you start from this dependence alphabet. So C is dependent from A and B. And you obtain this infinite quarter grid tree. That is, you start from an infinite quarter grid. Then, from any vertex of this infinite quarter grid, you have an edge labeled by C to the origin of a new infinite quarter grid, and so on. So this is an example of trail suffix automaton. And so we can prove that the family of trail suffix automata is in fact closed under the two operations of level length synchronization and level length superposition. And so we have Boolean algebra. We have various Boolean algebra from the family of trail suffix automata. So we just have to consider a deterministic trail suffix automaton, and all the languages that are accepted by deterministic trail suffix automata that are length reducible to this H form a Boolean algebra. So now let us consider vector addition systems. So first, observe that for the dependence relation of a trace monoid, we have two extreme cases. First, we can have for the dependence relation, in fact, the total relation. Then a trace suffix automaton is just a word suffix automaton. But we can also have for the dependence relation, in fact, the equality. And then we will say that we have a vector addition system. So here, a vector addition system is just a trail suffix automaton over, finally, a commutative monoid. So here you can see how a two-dimensional vector of natural numbers is encoded on an alphabet with two letters because it's a two-dimensional vector. And so you have XX and Y. So here is the first example of vector addition system, and we can see how trail suffix automata over commutative monoid encode usual vector addition systems. For example, the letter A was labeling the vector 2-1, and this is translated into trail suffix automata as a rule. With the trace of y, because the minus one implies that we have to remove y, and we have for the white hand side the trace of xx. So observe that the vector addition systems that we have are not usual because of the context that are level regular. But it is a more general form of vector addition system. So we have that the family of vector addition systems is closed under level length synchronization and level length superposition. So we have various Boolean algebra from vector addition system. We just have to fix to consider any deterministic vector addition system, and all the languages accepted by deterministic vector addition systems that are length reducible to this H form a Boolean algebra. So now, let us consider the two operations of level length synchronization and superposition. First, we consider the synchronization of two traces over disjoint trace monoid. It's just the product. In terms of Fouettard normal forms, we just have to make the union of the corresponding levels. So here you have the synchronization. And we will speak about level length synchronization just if S and T have the same length and it is not defined otherwise. So now we can give the formal definition of level length synchronization of automata. So it is just a graph over level length synchronizations of vertices of G1 and G2. And so you have an edge labeled by A in the level length synchronization. This edge labeled by A arises from edges labeled by A in G1 and G2, such that sources of the edges of these edges and goals of these edges have the same length. And moreover, you make the level length synchronization of the initial vertices and the final vertices. And so we have this this lemma, that is, if G1 and G2 are trace automata that are length reducible to an automaton H, suppose moreover that they are deterministic, then the level length synchronization is a deterministic automaton. Moreover, it is length reducible to H. And the level length synchronization accepts exactly the intersection. So now we turn to level length superposition, that is a little more technical. So I don't give the formal definition because it is a little bit technical, but it is in the paper. But let us explain in this slide. So just we consider the simpler case, where G and H are deterministic and G is length reducible to H. So here are some examples. And so we have to construct an automaton that accepts exactly the difference of language. So first, observe that there are two cases. The first one, a word is accepted by H and is completely readable in G. So this word, so we have to consider now the level length synchronization of H and overline G. That is, the automaton obtained from G by inversing the finality, by declaring final the vertices that were not final, and vice versa. But we can also have the case where a word is accepted by H and just a strict prefix of this word is readable in G. So we have to add some edges. And here we have some edges that allow the run going on this word. And observe that we need that this level length superposition is length reducible to H. So we have to preserve that the H component of this vertex is longer than the G component. And so we have this lemma that if G and H, in fact, are deterministic trace automata such that G is length reducible to H, then the level length superposition is a deterministic automaton. It is length reducible to H, and it accepts exactly the difference of language. So we can consider, for example, the notion of visibly languages of vector addition systems. In fact, it will be just the vector addition systems that are length reducible to a given visibly pushdown automaton. So we have this this notion, this Boolean algebra. Just observe that, for example, if we consider this triple of disjoint alphabets, this context-free language that is known, that is not a visibly pushdown language, is a visibly language of vector addition system. This context-sensitive language, AN, BN, CN, is a visibly language of vector addition system. So we have this notion of visibly vector addition system language. So to conclude, we have considered Mazurkiewicz traces to take concurrent systems into account. We define two operations, level length synchronization and level length superposition over trace automata. We have various Boolean algebra from trace suffix automata and from vector addition system, seen as trace suffix automata over a commutative monoid. In fact, we have various Boolean algebra from any family of trace automata closed under the two operations. We have this notion of Boolean algebra of visibly languages of vector addition system. And as a future work, we can consider, for example, a logical characterization of the visibly vector addition system languages.
Are there any questions? How do you define the language of a vector addition system? What's the definition?
The definition, in fact, is That is, we have, but we, in fact, we consider only deterministic vector addition systems. So this set of initial vertices is just a singleton. And but here, a level regular set as the final vertices.
Just because in your example, I think the vector addition system is exactly the same as the one. I think we have the AM.
The example of level. Yes, we have this language that is not a visibly pushed down language. So it becomes. And we have some context sensitive languages.
Is it possible to have this language? To have
this one? This one?
Yes.
Yes?
Okay.
But visibly vector addition system, but it's not a visibly pushed down language.
Okay, if not, let's thank the speaker again.